Hey guys, it's Shonda Hunt here, and today I'm coming to you with a quick demo to show you a way to get rid of your tracking markers. Pretty easy, simple, and all you need to do is create a mat and two erode nodes. So let's get started. First, we'll go ahead and create our mat. So we'll just draw some rotos around each of these tracking markers. This technique works on blue and green screens of different types. So not just monitor comps, you can use them on a variety of different types of blue and green screen footage. So we have our mats. Now the other thing we want to make sure is that our roto resolution or format is the same as our plate. So let's go ahead and change that. So now that we have our roto, we'll go ahead and create our erode nodes. And once we have one erode, we can go ahead and connect it to the roto. And what we want to do, actually, we'll also create our second erode node, because what we're going to do is we're going to expression link these two erode nodes together. So let's go ahead and create our second one. If you double tap the space bar, the tab key, it'll bring up the last node that you imported, and you can just bring it in quickly without having to type it out. And here, so we have our first erode, and now we have our second. And we're going to want the one to be positive, and we're going to want the second one to be negative. So we'll set an expression so that whenever we're adjusting the top erode, the bottom one will also automatically adjust. And to show you, I'll just change this. Let's take a look. If we start eroding, I'll close one of them so we make sure we're viewing the right one. And let's go ahead and simply just start sliding that around. And you can see those tracking markers start to disappear. So we have that. And now we want to expression link the two together. So if you hold down Control, you'll get a little hand and you can drag the value here, and it'll create an expression link. And as I said earlier, we do want one of them to be positive and one of them to be negative. So what we'll do with this one, we'll left click, go down to edit expression, and we'll just add a negative here. So that'll give us the opposite. So now we have our negative and we have our positive expression linked. If we view, let's connect our second erode to the mask first, and then we'll view it. And now we can dial these in. So let's view in our second erode. Let's keep dialing this in. See, can we get something pretty clean? Yeah, if we move it over a little further, we see now we have all the markers gone. So this is just a very quick way to get rid of your tracking markers. If you needed to add a blur or anything, you could. We don't really need to add one in this case. And you could also just go ahead and create a mask around your markers so that you're only using the part of this that you need to. So let's just step through that. I go to my markers again. I did draw some. My first roto shapes were a little bit loose. If I wanted to tighten these up so I'm only affecting these areas, and I'll show you an example of what I'm talking about. You could even go as far as simply to draw a roto right around your markers if you wanted to keep more of the plate. You could do something like this where you're having a more precise shape around your markers. And again, making sure our format is set to match the plate so that our roto is lining up. And then we could just max that out. So we'll change this operation to mask. And then we can merge that over the plate. And that way, we're keeping as much of the plate as we need to and only affecting the areas that we want. So